Buenos Dias Gunners Collective, back at it like a smack at it. And as you can tell by today's thumbnail, we're going to get into it, man. We're going to do it in a menudo style, and in that fashion, we're going to talk about this guy, Ariel Guzar. Now, I know it's kind of an older case out of San Jose, California, but at the same time, I felt that if for no other reason, man, I should have let it be known and put my little spin on it and put my little take on what happened, what went down, and, you know, what was the case, basically. So this guy, Ariel Guzar, right, out of San Jose, California, a well-known individual, around San Jose. You know, I got a lot of homeboys out of the San Jose area, Santa Clara County, all that area, man. And his name was ringing bells. And I don't mean ringing bells in a hitter fashion or anything of the such. I mean ringing bells, basically. His name was out there because he was a tattoo artist. But he quietly has his kept, not even his name, but that of his baby's mama. She's a well-known tattoo artist out of the San Jose, California area. One Hustleena or Hus Baby, right? Now those of you know that are in the tattoo industry or know anything about tattoos up in Northern California, then you know that her name rocks the bells, right? She's a pretty good tattoo artist, well known, and has been known in the San Jose area to put the tinta down a time or two, and in that fashion. Anyway, so trip out. I wanted to talk about this because, you know, I was chopping it up with the homeboy from San Jose, and he was like, "Hey, I hear you doing your little spills and doing your little take on this and that. What's up with this cat?" I said, man, I haven't heard that name for years. Now, I actually knew him personally. Yes, I did know Ariel personally. And when I met him, man, he was just your simple average Norteño or Northerner. And, I mean, he was just out there doing tattoos and you know, doing what basically you do out there in Seoul, you know, just wiggle a little bit. But at the same time, this guy had a lot going on. Besides doing tattoos and maintaining as a soldado out there in Seoul, he was doing some human trafficking. Now, this is an old case. It's already, he's been sentenced on it. You know, ain't nothing new. I ain't giving you guys no game. I ain't fucking throwing him under the bus. So let's get fuck him anyways. And in that fashion, bang, bang. We're going to do it like this. Human trafficking. You know, that's a big thing, you know, nowadays. And it's been big for a long time. You've had vatos that, you know, and even women, you know, because there was a woman involved in this case that, you know, they think there's some type of PI. They think they're pandering, and in that fashion, they think there's some type of pimp. And so I was scared they're going to go get these younger women or even males sometimes. And they're going to get them, and they're going to fucking turn them out and turn them into fucking whatever they think they're going to turn them into and do a move. And Spencer, I've been in traffic for a fucking hour now, and it's finally moving. Somebody got fucking smashed. Bang, bang. Anyway, so let's get back to this cat. This dude, Ariel, right? He got caught up in a human trafficking case where there was minors involved. Okay, so the moment I heard the word minor back in the days when this shit went down, I knew it was at that exact moment right there. So I was scared. Joto generation, right? He had a whole lot of flaws in his get down, right? Get down first, man. If you got to go out, then you got to pimp and you got to pan around a hoe or do whatever you feel you have to do. Sasuke, all money is good money. Do whatever it is you got to do. But when you start involving minors, young children, raza, whatever the case may be, man, now we got a problem. Sasuke, we got a big problem. And in that fashion, problem being that that is a very degenerate act. That right there in itself is a sickness. It's a disease, you know, when people tend to do shit like that. But at the same time, what I wasn't feeling and what I'm not feeling is the fact that this guy still thought he was going to carry a big name around. Sanjo still thought he was somebody, right? So I was scared the day his fucking picture, his fucking mascara was right there in that newspaper. Game over. Bang, bang. Flip, flip. Game over, right? And not just game over for coming from my perspective, but game over as far as your career as being a Norteño, as far as being a human being, game over, right? We all know that there's a big stigma that goes on with ratas and dropouts and ex-gang members and whatever the case may be. However you feel, get it off your chest. Get the fuck off where you're mad at, right? Hey, that's no big deal. But when it comes to chomos or rapos or things of that nature, I think we all can agree, right? That's the bottom of the barrel. Sasuke, scraper. We call them scrapers where I'm from. You know what I mean? They're scraping. And then when it involves minors and things of that nature, man, they're better off gone. And in that fashion, gone however you want to get rid of them. It doesn't matter to me. Fucking do it. Just do it fast, right? If I can, I will. But this guy Ariel, man, like I said, he was well known out of the San Jose area just based on who his old lady was. You know, his old lady semi-famous, Husselina, Hus baby. Or at that time, she was his, she, you know, it's his baby's mom. She wasn't with him. The bomb also already had fucking knocked him another one, and he was going for broke. So it's okay. He was broke too at that time. Anyways, he found himself human trafficking. How he got caught up and aligned in this fucking mix, I don't know. A lot of autos get fucking caught up in a lot of different things. And Sasuke, to each their own, you know. But when it comes to something as grimy and as dirtbag as that, Sasuke, ding dong, bitch, you're dead. I hope you're dead, right? Fuck you. Follow the drip, homie. You know, you're no better than your average fucking piece of shit dude walking the yardas over there in the SNYs that fucking have some weirdo shit on their case. You know, you're basically, you fall right in line. Birds of a feather flock together. So that's getting in that fashion. But so this guy Ariel, you know, being that he had a little sway, a little name out there in Sanjo, thought that if for no other reason, Vatos were gonna look past that. And I, man, as anyone should know, man, anyone that's been in the game a while and any grown man or woman knows, there is no justifying those actions. There's no justifying what he did. And, you know, the case was pretty big. It was unprecedented up there in Northern California just based on who he was. And a lot of people knew him. Like I said, I knew him personally. We weren't on a friendship basis, more merely an associate. I'd go out there and wiggle and song and get tattoos and, you know, hang around with a certain crowd, a selective crowd of homeboys that I knew. And he happened to be at a couple parties. And, you know, it was what it was. I met him in passing. Hey, what's up? Hi, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Orale. In that fashion. You know what I mean? I didn't wham him or bam him, but Sasuke, I'm sure someone did. And if they haven't, I'm sure they're doing it now. But look, in any case, quietly as it kept, the Vato got caught up in this fucking sex trafficking case where it involved minors, right? So he fought the case for a while. It was him and some fucking piruja, some jaina that got caught up with them. And she's no better than him, man. Doesn't matter if you're man or woman, man. Anytime you take advantage of a child, a minor, then you're all in the same fucking boat. Titanic, I hope it sinks. Bang, bang. And it will. And he ended up taking a deal on the case. He ended up taking a deal. He has to register for life as a sex offender, which, you know, I mean, they should have just fucking did him in. But, you know, Sasuke, it seems like they look out for them, especially in the state of California. It happens. But he did take, I believe it was 17 years. And that was that. You know, he took 17 years on this very degenerate act that he did, you know, human trafficking. Now, this human trafficking thing has been, it's been publicized and polarized, you know, in the social media, on TV, movies. And it's an epidemic. It's something that's been going on for several years, you know, from the beginning of time, since the fucking Geico caveman was rocking, you know what I mean? But at the same time, man, it's becoming more commonplace where you're starting to see it a lot. And, you know, I'm not going to sit here and say, hey, if you're a PI, a pimp, or whatever the fuck you call yourself, you're in the wrong. Hey, Sasuke, if she wants to go out there and hoe, let that hoe know. You know what I mean? Shit, go out there and get that money. And if she wants to give it to the next motherfucker, hey, guess what? Follow the drip. Follow the drip. You know what I mean? How can you just leave her standing alone in a world that's so cold? But when it starts to involve fucking minors, it's at that exact moment in time when we got a problem. Oh, yes, there will be sangre, right? There's a very bad problem. And the problem is that this right here is just a despicable act. You know, and I don't give a fuck if it's a Norteño, a Sureño, a Crip, a Blood, or a Dorte thug. I don't give a fuck who's choosing to do this. At the same time, man, you're all in the same fucking boat, and that's why you guys are all on the same yarda, right? Kicking it amongst your own degenerate ass own. It's just something that can never be reprimanded, can never be looked upon as anything but what it is, right? And that's just a despicable act. Like I say, I myself know of a lot of different cases, man, where guys get caught up. You know, there was one out of my area, out of Merced, California. You know, a lot of people ask about him all the time. And I always skirt around the subject, man, because I never want to give people the rundown into what was going on with this guy. I actually went to school with him, but he's one young gangster droop, right? Devin Bradford from the city of Merced. He was a well-known rapper, used to be hooked up with Low Down for a minute, Low Town Records, whatever the fuck it was. And he was out there doing it, man. You know, the Vato had spit, he could rap, but that don't mean nothing, homie. You know, he got caught up and the same type of thing. Maybe it wasn't sex trafficking, but as a minor, but he was dealing with minors, you know, and he got caught up, he got convicted, he's doing tiempo, and c'est la vie, vámonos a la verga, fuck you. And in that fashion, that's what it is, you know? So I just wanted to say that fucking, you know, when it comes to this type of things, I don't really like to speak on them, because I think the world's better off without that type of shit. But at the same time, sometimes it has to be brought to the light and has to be brought to attention. You know, now I can only wonder and think how Hustlina felt to have a baby dad that was that type of fucking character. You know what I mean? Her being well known in the San Jose area, she wiggles, you know, she's well known in the Raza as far as one of the best tattoo artists out of Northern California and Califas period, you know, just think of what she had to go through. And man, I've seen pictures of this Hustlina character herself, man. She had her old man's, her ex-old man, you know, the baby daddy's name, Ariel, real big, blasted across her stomach. And just think, every time she has to look at her stomach, she's like, dispensa la tira, con permiso. Look at what I got on my stomach. You know what I mean? This motherfucking despicable ass character. But it happens, bro. It happens, and I mean, that's just the way it is. Now, I wanted to talk about it because one of the homeboys brought it to my attention, was like, hey, you should fucking do something on this, bro. And I said, you know what? I don't like to give these guys a fucking minute of my airtime. I don't like to talk about these kind of guys because it's like you're keeping their name shining, right? And when they should be buried, bro. But at the same time, like I said, if no one's going to fucking put it out there, then I will. This guy, Ariel, man, was a Norteño. Yes, he was a Norteño soldado, a Northerner, whatever he was. He never had status, but he was just a regular old fucking giddy up, bang, bang Northerner. But he did shit like that. You know, and this goes to show you, man, that anybody and everybody, man, from every group, faction, every walk in life, man, can get caught up in things like this. I'm not going to sit here and defend him saying, oh, he used to be a homie. Oh, that means we got to give him the benefit of the doubt. Fuck him. You know what I mean? Hey, he went to court. That was his fucking benefit of the doubt. That was that. He took a deal. So Sasuke, that means he admitted guilt. That means he did that shit. And in that fashion, that's just the way it's fucking going to go as far as I'm concerned. Am I going to give that guy any more shine or any more airtime? Hey, fuck you, Holmes. La primera. Hell nah, man. He ain't got nothing coming. I just put it out there because the homeboy got at me and said, you should do it. So I did it. Now, as far as Devin Bradford, I know a lot of people are going to DM me, ask about him. That's the case, man. Look it up. Google it. I've been asked a lot of times, you know, what's up with Young Gangsta Drew? His shit slaps. Yeah, well, someone should slap him in his fucking mouth. Because he got caught up on that minor shit too. And that's just, you know, it's just the way it is. You know, I can't sit here and tell you guys the intricacies and the details into that exact case. But I will tell you, when it was brought to my attention, hey, I wasn't surprised. And I'm going to tell you a little story of why I wasn't surprised. So I used to live in these fucking apartments in Merced, chilling with my homegirl, Mada, sad girl from the town, and another homegirl. You know, we were just doing our thing, man. We were barely trying to make it, but we were making it. And I remember that he used to stay with some little white girl and her dad right in the same apartment complex. Now, me not knowing what was going on, you know, I never got into his business. I tell you the truth, I never really cared for Devin ever since we were younger and in school. He always thought he was somebody. And I remember the day I had to fucking run up on him and he showed me that he was a nobody, right? So we'll just leave it like that. But my homegirl, she did like to go over there and wiggle with this guy that was fucking around the way. And one day she comes to me and she looks kind of like, I don't know, kind of in shock. And I said, what's up, sad girl? She said, hey, you know that fool Gangster Droop? I said, yeah, I know that baboso, right? She said, yeah, that fool's over there fucking with some little young girl. And I said, what you mean, right? It's that little white girl over there. She ain't number 14 years old. I said, what? Right? Bitch. Hey, that was all it took. Of course, I strapped on the fucking Converse, the Chuck Taylors one time, and I went to go see what time it was. Of course, when I got there, he tried to plea bargain, say, well, that wasn't the case. That was just his homegirl. I said, how the fuck your homegirl 14 years old, bro? I don't got no fucking 14-year-old homegirls at the age of 25, right? But, hey, you know, this was the way of his justifying it. And that's a true story. Of course, I got at him in the most vicious type of fashion. He didn't want the pleito. He just wanted to stay rapping. And that's what it was, you know. And I would trip because later on in life, after I fell off, after I became non-active, he still was functioning and kicking it with active Norteños, all up in their music videos, all up in the Kool-Aid, all up in the flavor, right? A straight added fucking preservative. Yes, indeed. And I know, and I fucking knew exactly what time it was, and I would tell people, hey, that guy's a no good character. You'll see it all come out in the wash. Hey, all the fucking cagada rises to the top, and you blow it off, and that's what it is, man. It's like that water in Tracy Prison. It's all fucking brown and murky, but it all rises to the top eventually. And it did. You know, it did, man. When these people have these degenerate ways, and they have this fucking disease and this sickness of doing things to minors or women, it's always going to come out. And when it does, you know, vatos should handle their business. You know, if I'm there, if I'm in the vicinity, sabes que, hey, it looks like, hey, bail me out, right? I need to get bailed out because it's going to fucking go down. And in that fashion, get a GoFundMe and bail Gunga now, right? What happened? He fucking sucked gangster drooping his jaw. Hey, and it'd be like that sometimes. You know, 209's really both vicious. But anyways, I just wanted to get into a couple of these stories and let you know that in no time, man, as a raza, as people, you know what I mean, and being for the people, by the people, should we condone these type of characters, man? You know, I don't give a fuck if he's my homeboy from my barrio, my own brother, my primo, my fucking sister's old man, ex-cousin's, sister-in-law's brother. Hey, fuck all of them, right? If you do anything to a minor or you're caught up in any type of weird shit like that, you can get it. You can get that business, you know what I mean? Anyone can get it, but at the same time, you can get it just a little bit more with the pinchy cherry on top. And that's just how it's going to go down. So as far as this Vato Ariel, this Vato Young Gangster Droop, and I know there's been many, many more. Spencer, if I'm not touching on it. You know, they get what they got coming to them. You know, everything, what goes around, comes around. So I was scared, every degenerate act that you put the minors through, or you put those women through, I hope, Sasuke, you get fucking bang banged and it comes back, you know, in a 10-inch fashion, you know what I mean? And that's just what it is. Anyways, yeah, I just wanted to touch on that, let the gente know that at the same time, man, Gun is pushing right here for the people, by the people, and we're going to continue as such. So I hope that you move fast with a purpose. I hope that you got everything that you want coming to you. That's called hustling. You know what I mean? You got to get up, get out, and get something. There ain't nothing to it but to do it. As you can see, it's early morning. I'm on the road. Hey, Sasuke, hey, I need some action tonight. I'm about to go get my work on because that's what I do. Then I'm going to work out and I'm going to make things happen. Because, hey, bro, that's what the fuck time it is. When you're a raza, when you're a real motherfucker, you go out there and make it happen. Saca la bolsita, or I'm going to go out and get that. Either way, I'm going to stay fucking papered up. That's just what it is. Like I said, man, for the people, by the people, the Gun. Fuck all those weirdos. Bang, bang.